Folks, we have a new view of the universe. NASA releasing a slew of new full-colour infrared images demonstrating what the largest space telescope ever built, known as the James Webb, is capable of. And you are looking at some of the deepest views of space ever captured. And as we've been on air, they have just, at NASA, released a new image. I want to bring back Miles O'Brien, who has been walking us through what we are seeing and the significance of these images. Miles, if you're with me, this, our viewers are seeing, is the third big reveal, as it were, today. Tell us what we're seeing and why this matters.
This is the Southern Ring Nebula, Becky, like it has never been seen before. That blue center is hotter temperature, and it is a view which is difficult, actually impossible for other telescopes to obtain. If you think about some of the great Hubble Space Telescope images, those kind of cloudy images of nebula, what is effective and interesting about the Webb Space Telescope is it is in the infrared spectrum, which allows it to go to more distant reaches of the universe. Because what happens is the light spectrum gets stretched as the universe expands. And so to see the farthest distances, you need to be in the infrared. But the infrared has another advantage in that you can see through those clouds and see what's going on behind them. And so while the clouds are kind of fun images to look at and they're beautiful, for scientists, they want to peer through the clouds. And that's what this image is telling you. You can see what's going on underneath the clouds, as well as understanding the tremendous beauty. I mean, you can't help but look at that and not say, wow, that is beautiful.
Mm. Let's just go back to NASA and to their live broadcast and just hear what they've got to say.
Okay, Amber, so here it is. Can you walk us through the final image reveal?
Absolutely. Here we go.
The last image is... Wow, look at that. So, Amber, can you tell us a bit about what we're seeing here?
Of course. This stunning vista of the cosmic cliffs of the Carina Nebula reveals new details about this vast stellar nursery. Today, for the first time, we're seeing brand new stars that were previously completely hidden from our view.
There's something you want to point out here?
Absolutely. So, honestly, it took me a while to even figure out what to call out in this image. There's just so much going on here. It's so beautiful. One thing that really, really stands out to me is you sort of get this sense of depth and texture from this new data. There's a lot going on. To call out a few specifics, first of all, in general, the Carina Nebula is a nearby star-forming region within our own Milky Way galaxy, about 7,600 light years away. And in this view, we see some great examples, first of all, of hundreds of new stars that we've never seen before. We see examples of bubbles and cavities and jets that are being blown out by these newborn stars. We even see some galaxies sort of lurking in the background up here. We see examples of structures that, honestly, we don't even know what they are. Like, what's going on here? The data is just so rich.
And there's something really special about the infrared. Infrared can actually see deeper into these star-forming regions.
Absolutely. That's one of the great things about infrared is it really does reveal what's going on here in a really cosmic sense. And in general, what's happening in sort of this overall landscape is we have these gigantic, hot, young stars up here to the top of this rim, and the radiation and stellar winds from those stars is sort of pushing down and running into all of this. This is gas and dust, and of course we know that gas and dust is great raw material for newborn stars and baby planets. But there's a flip side to this story and also a little bit of a mystery, because these same processes can serve to sort of erode away this material and stop star formation. So we have this sort of delicate balance going on of new stars being formed, but at the same time, the star formation is being halted. And for me, when I see an image like this, I can't help but think about scale. You know, every dot of light we see here is an individual star, not unlike our sun, And many of these likely also have planets. And it just reminds me that, you know, our sun and our planets and ultimately us were formed out of the same kind of stuff that we see here. We humans really are connected to the universe. We're made of the same stuff in this beautiful landscape.
And actually, the Carina Nebula was one of my favorite images from Hubble. So Hubble looked at this as well, right?
Absolutely, yeah. The Hubble image of this is also spectacular. We saw it in a different kind of light when Hubble took an image of this particular nebula. And then you can see amazing things with Hubble, but when we zoom in to this new image, we're able to see so much more detail. And of course, all of us, you know, I grew up on Hubble, and all of us love Hubble. And I'm so excited to see what these two amazing observatories are able to do really in tandem with each other.
Thank you so much. And again, congratulations. It's been a pleasure to be working on this with you. I'm just amazed by what's been going on.
I am too. Thank you.
So as we're wrapping up, one of the things that I really have to say is
let's bring Miles O'Brien back, CNN's aerospace analyst and science correspondent for PBS NewsHour. I mean, I really took a sharp intake of breath when I saw this new image.
Yeah.
What do you
think? I'm a little beklempt, Becky. I am. I really am. I'm a little misty. I didn't expect to be affected this way, but it's really... It's so beautiful and stunning and data rich too. You know, the scientists see it in a different way, but you know, I'm more of a right brain guy. When I look at that, I think of the beauty of the creation in which we live is pretty stunning. Mm.
Just explain what we are seeing here. I mean, what
this is the
Carina
Nebula. Mm. Yeah, this is a nursery. It looks like it could be, you know, the Rocky Mountains on a starry night. With a hat tip to Van Gogh here, he was prescient in what he painted. But this is, it's a nursery. This is where stars are born, nebula. That cloudy stuff ultimately congeals and creates stars and planets and solar systems and galaxies. And so this is the ability to see something deep, deep, deep back in time, and what it looked like as those stars were forming billions of years ago. The Carina Nebula, 7,600 light years away. You do the conversion on how far away that is in distance. And it's several times larger than our sun, many of these stars. And what's great, you know, when you hear a scientist saying, you know, we're looking at that object, and Amber Strawn is one of the best, we're looking at that object, we're not even sure what the heck that is. That proves... that they've done something right here, right? They are on the edge of big discoveries here. And who knows what we're going to find out. It's going to be a fun ride, I think.
Just before I let you go, this is the James Webb Space Telescope. And as the guys were just pointing out, I mean, this hasn't been an easy run to get to this point. What sort of budget are we talking about here for the hardware, as it were? What does it take to continue to finance an operation like this?
It's a $10 billion operation, and that's about twice as much as was first imagined back in 1995 when they first started talking about it. But, you know, they were optimistic that they could do it. They really didn't know how they were going to do it. So how do you estimate? I tell all my friends at NASA, whatever number you come up with, just double it, because it will be double. And sure enough, here it is. But I'll tell you honestly, in the grand scheme, is it worth $10 billion? That's less than some weapon systems at the Pentagon. I would trade these images for a weapon system any day of the week. How about you?
Yeah, well, absolutely. Absolutely. Not a shadow of a doubt. This has been amazing. Thank you for making time for us today. As I say, it's always a pleasure to have you on, Miles. And just thank you for walking us through what has been some remarkable imagery revealed with such fanfare by NASA today in what has been their live broadcast that we've been dipping in and out of. Thank you very much.